Hello, and welcome to this 5-minute FarmDoc video. I'm Henrique Monaco from the University of Illinois, and today we'll talk about the growth in Brazil's soybean yields. Brazil has emerged as a dominant soybean producer. This is due to two main factors: acreage expansion, as discussed in other FarmDocs, but also due to yield increase. However, this growth in yields varies significantly within regions. Today, we will discuss how yields evolved across Brazil's main growing regions, discussing where are areas with growth potential, along with possible implications for U.S. and global markets. Let's start with the big picture. Looking at data from 1974 through 2023, Brazil's soybean yields have grown at a faster pace than the United States yields. While U.S. soybean yields have grown 0.51 bushels per year, Brazil's yields have increased by about 0.61 bushels annually. Brazil's yields were also significantly lower than U.S. yields, but have recently reached comparable levels, which reflects substantial investments in agricultural technology, improved farm practices, and scientific advancements. Yet, there are significant regional variations within Brazil, as we will discuss next. Brazil's soybean production can be divided into four main regions, each with distinct yield characteristics. First, we have the South region. This is one of Brazil's earliest soybean growing areas, and currently accounts for about 28% of national production. Climate variability is a major factor, especially in the southern part, which faces more irregular rainfall patterns. This region has experienced annual yield increases of 0.59 bushels per year, slightly below the national average. But climate challenges translate into a lot of variation within this region, with trend yields ranging from 0.25 to 0.93 bushels per year. Second, we have the Center-West region, which includes Mato Grosso, Brazil's larger soybean producer state. This region produced nearly 50% of Brazil's soybeans in the last year. Large farm scale provide great capacity for investments in new agricultural technologies, which led to an annual increase in yields of 0.65 bushels per year. The Center-West also benefits from a well-defined wet and dry seasons, and although there is some variability in the trend yields, the lowest values remains in line with the U.S. trend levels. Third is Matopiba, Brazil's newest agricultural frontier. This region accounted for 14% of production in the last year and shows strong yield growth of 0.64 bushels annually. Much of this growth comes from converting pasture land to cropland. Finally, the Southeast region contributes to about 8% of production and has moderate but highly variable yield growth. Soybeans in this region competes with high-value crops like sugarcane, leaving its production primarily to the most productive areas. So, where is Brazil's yield growth headed? When we compare the average of yields from the past 5 years with the trend yields, some clear patterns emerge. The South region, despite being well-established, remains susceptible to climate variability. The Southeast shows significant yield variability, but has limited growth for acreage expansion. Thus, both South and Southeast regions will likely make only marginal contributions to Brazil's overall production growth. Brazil's future growth will likely be focused on the Center-West and Matopiba regions. Matopiba still has considerable room for improving yields, which potentially can approach Center-West levels, which are already higher than U.S. average levels. Together, the Matopiba and Center-West regions accounted for 65% of national production and have significant potential for both yield improvement, but also acreage expansion through pasture land conversion, as discussed in other farm docs. So what does it mean for global markets and U.S. producers? First, Brazil's yield growth shows no signs of slowing down. All regions in Brazil are experiencing faster yield growth compared to the U.S. national average. I must note that the U.S. also exhibits regional differences in soybean production, and comparisons with specific areas could highlight variations in trend yields and yield levels between these two countries. Furthermore, caution is needed when using these trends to project yields far in the future, since they are very sensitive to the time period analyzed. Second, the Center-West and Matopiba regions will be the key areas to watch, as they have both yield improvement potential and room for expansion. Finally, Brazil's future growth will depend on continuing investments in infrastructure, research, and policies that can support efficiency and resilience. For U.S. producers, understanding these trends helps in preparing for future market competition. Thank you for watching.